Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America. We begin with a Filipino-American historian warning that the U.S. Supreme Court's landmark ruling issued on Monday, granting presidents immunity for official acts, strikes a deeply alarming chord among Americans.
The Supreme Court basically just handed, you know, additional protections to the executive branch, and in a way is kind of giving this branch of government additional powers.
History professor James Zarzadilla says the historic ruling undermines the balance of power among the three branches of the United States government, which are meant to have equal authority.
What we've been seeing with these recent rulings is the Supreme Court has not only shown it is a conservative leaning or solidly conservative court, beyond that, it's actually what is being demonstrated and put on full display is that this is a Trump court.
The ruling originated from a case filed by former President Donald Trump's lawyers to dismiss a federal indictment against him. Trump faces charges for allegedly attempting to overturn the 2020 elections during the chaotic final days of his presidency. His lawyers argue that a president has absolute immunity from criminal prosecution. In a 6-3 decision, the justices granted Trump a partial victory, ruling that former U.S. presidents cannot be prosecuted for official actions taken while in office. Meanwhile, Trump's July 11 sentencing in his New York hush money case has been pushed back to September 18 following the Supreme Court's ruling on presidential immunity. On May 30, a Manhattan jury found Trump guilty of 34 counts of falsifying records connected to a hush money payment to adult film star Stormy Daniels ahead of the 2016 presidential election. But Trump's lawyers sent Judge Juan Merchan a letter on Monday seeking permission to argue his conviction to be completely tossed out. The Manhattan District Attorney's Office then said that they don't object to give Trump a chance to argue his case. The delay would allow Trump's lawyers to file a formal motion to toss out the conviction, for prosecutors to respond, and for Judge Merchan to rule. Finally, the Philippine Independence Day festivities on the East Coast came to a close with the first ever Pistahang Bayan organized by the Philippine Consulate General held in Jersey City, New Jersey on Sunday. The culmination of a month-long celebration of the 126th anniversary of Araw ng Kalayaan celebrated Philippine culture and gathered PhilAms from the 10 states covered by the New York Consulate. The celebration included a showcase of vibrant regional dances and original Filipino music. And also a mini sports fest. And a palaro of fun Filipino games.
Napaka-importante na magkaroon ng sense of unity. Iisang bansa tayo, iisang lahi, iisang minamahal na bandila.
And those are the news-making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.
Now, the White House acknowledging President Joe Biden's poor showing during last week's debate. The widely panned performance has prompted calls for Biden to step aside as the Democratic presidential nominee. Former House Speaker Nancy Pelosi has also raised questions on whether Biden's debate performance was a one-night thing or a broader health problem. But Pelosi also says Trump should be given the same scrutiny.
What I can say is that, just to take a step back, it was a bad night. We understand that it was a bad night. And the president has spoken to this. And he understands that. We have released thorough reports from his medical team every year since he's been in office. That is something that we have been pretty consistent about.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu released a video statement in response to a New York Times article. Quoting security officials, the publication reported Tuesday, Israel's military leadership wants a ceasefire with Hamas if a bigger war breaks out in its northern front with Lebanon. Netanyahu insisting Israel won't stop the war in Gaza until it achieves all its goals, which include the elimination of Hamas and the release of all hostages. The statement comes as Israeli forces advance further into southern Gaza in what could be part of a final push of Israel's intensive military operations. The death toll in a stampede at a Hindu religious festival in northern India climbs to 116. Most of the casualties were women and children. At least 18 more were injured. One official said the stampede happened due to overcrowding. According to initial reports, more than 15,000 people gathered for the event, which had permission for about 5,000. Stampedes are relatively common during large religious gatherings in India and are often blamed on poor crowd management. Hurricane Beryl strengthens to a Category 5 storm after sweeping through parts of the Caribbean, causing extensive damage and leaving many without power. At least two people have reportedly been killed. A Category 5 hurricane brings winds of 252 kilometers per hour or higher, capable of causing catastrophic damage. The World Meteorological Association says Beryl sets a very dangerous tone.
It's the earliest Category 5 hurricane on record in the Atlantic, Caribbean, and Central American basin. And it sets a precedent for what we fear is going to be a very, very, very active, a very, very dangerous hurricane season, which will impact the entire basin.
Beryl is expected to weaken to a Category 4 before hitting Jamaica Wednesday and the Cayman Islands later in the week. Despite not being in the path of the storm, the Dominican Republic is also on alert, especially its southern coast.